Take your hobby to the next level with a quality racing rig that works great with a PS3, Xbox 360, and a PC. Omega Racing Simulator is compatible with a wide range of steering wheels, including Logitech, Fanatic, Thrustmaster, and more. The GT Omega is available now worldwide by going to www.gtomegaracing.com.
Hello everybody, and it is Monday night for qualifying 2 for our Le Mans week. We are here qualifying for, well, we had a qualifying session last night for the US, they kicked off our Le Mans week, and tonight we've got the rest of the guys going for the Monday session, another qualifying session on Wednesday night, and then the final two on Friday, both UK and US Central Time. Well, I'm your host, Richard Millard, Richie59. I've got Duncan Ray, Selective Rogue in the box.
Make sure if I'm mute. Hello, hello.
And Mark Brown Jr., aka LMR Darth Mario, who is hosting this lobby, so you may not be in the chat at the moment. Yeah, unfortunately, we do not have Adrian tonight. He's working. He's working night shift. So, Adrian, if you're watching, hi.
And I think Jake's busy as well. I think Jake was over... I'm not too sure. Actually, was he in Russia for the... was he down in London for the commentary on the World Series Bow Runner? So I'm not too sure if anyone saw that in Eurosports on Saturday. He was doing the commentary then, so he'll be with us on Saturday. So it'd be great to see if Jake's around as well at some point this week.
Yep, I think Jake will be doing some kind of promo material with us as well as we lead up to the start of Le Mans.
Yeah, I can't really go into that, it's going to be quite good.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty good. Friday night we will have our usual fun night sort of support races. We have the Open Cup returning once again, so it's A600 cars. And we will have the support race, the Le Mans special support race, which we've not announced details for yet. However, it will be the classic Le Mans cars, so sort of from the sort of 90s, early 2000s era. So yeah, we're very excited for that.
It'll be very good. I just must say, I'm actually looking really forward to this. Obviously, it's gone past the past weekend. Le Mans 24 Hours have really pumped me up for this event. obviously such sad circumstances, so we'll be doing something special for the start of the race. But I'm really looking forward to it. It's our fourth, is it a fourth 24-hour race official, or is it a third one? I can't remember how many we're counting.
I think it's officially our fourth one.
It's
the fourth one when we've done with like a big group of people.
Yes.
This marks 1 year to the sort of the race where we started doing our live streaming thing.
Yeah.
It was 1 year ago today that we started doing our first sort of live stream, and it seems to have become quite popular all over the Forza community. So
I think every Forza community is quite is taking it on board and starting to dabble in a bit of live stream, which is really good to see, because it's getting the time out there and how good the our drivers are across from all series. So it's good to see, and it's really good to see community bringing the Forza community come together for this event once more, and I'm really looking forward to it. We've got some really good names in the second of the qualifying sessions. I'll bring up the results from last night in a second if I'll go through them.
Sorry if the let me know feedback from sound quality, things like that. This is the first time we've ever streamed using Twitch, so yeah. Please expect a few hiccups and bumps along the way.
Exactly, so it's our first time using it, and myself and Richie are a bit nervous, and a bit rusty from doing commentary. We haven't done a live comms since Sebring.
Yeah, very much.
Sebring was our last one, so I really can't. Is that Martin? Yeah, Matt,
yeah,
Martin.
That's Martin. Hi, Martin.
Hi, Martin. Yeah, hi, Martin. You should come on Skype with your Barbie and Mike.
you'll be on like his 11th pint or something like that by now.
You'll miss Biggie. Anyway.
So, the race, well, we are, as we said, qualifying two. Mm-hmm. There was a qualifying session last night, which Mark was in. He was part of that. We've got the times from then.
Yep.
There's going to be quite a few good drivers in this lobby. We've got two lobbies running tonight. There's LMR Darth Mario's running the first one, and Stan the Man is...
First of all, hats off to Stan. I mean, that intro video was incredible. The music, the image, feels like a 70s retro.
Yeah, it was pretty amazing.
He's going on that 70s kind of Le Mans look, and I think it worked down really well, and he's got some good ideas for up and coming promotions as well. But I'm just going to go through the times from last night. So last night we had 5 GT drivers take to the track very early in the afternoon in the States, and we had 5 teams, and now the top team, the top driver was DTEP PR in the BMW M3 GT2, and he set a 4:01.882, and next to XPR Sportsman and Bloody Kane, both driving the for Team XPR, Sportsman in the Ferrari 458 and Kane in the Viper, and they were, I think they were like a couple of hundredths within each, but they did a 4:03.627 and a 4:03.003, and then we had the final two drivers, Monte Carlo Man in the SLR N Motorsport 2 BMW M3 GT2 set a 4:05.874, and we had, I'm going to pronounce this wrong, we need to start, I think what we're going to do is pull real drivers' names through when we do live comms. It's going to make life a bit more easier for us. Scalino in the CRA Team 3, which will be 4:09.201. In actual fact, I'm going to do that tonight. I'm going to start putting real night drivers' names against the drivers as well.
Yeah, we'll need to start doing the our Motors TV thing and start doing it all, real names and stuff like that.
Yeah, definitely works a lot better and a bit more professional, so it'll be good.
Just on a quick brief look through the field, quite a few Aston Martins in tonight. Mark VDS we're looking at just now with the other Takumi.
Oh, Martin Sainz had damage on the Mark VDS Aston.
Yeah, looks like he's had a scrape with the wall on the right-hand side, but I think it's before I got to it. There's no damage on the car, so it may have been...
Did you notice about this year's Le Mans, there were zero crashes between any categories of car?
Oh, really?
There were no crashes. No LMPs took out any GTs, or GTs took out MPs.
That's pretty impressive.
That is very impressive. Given the circumstances, I think it woke everyone up. So hats off to the drivers there. And hopefully we'll see the same kind of racing. I think very clean, fast racing. It's a 24-hour event, and I hope people realise that it's not all going to be one in the first run down to Mulsanne Corner. And,
yeah. The Sebring was good. There was a few issues at Sebring, however, a lot of the drivers that have taken part in the TEC this year are pretty experienced.
I think it's lag. I think people just got to understand if you see a driver lagging in inverted brackets, you've got to just give him a wide berth. I mean, you know, if you're quicker than him, you will get past him eventually. And just inform the lobby host if a particular driver is lagging quite particularly bad. So the lobby host might instruct that driver to, for safety reasons, if he's lagging across all the field, might ask him to pull over and let the field through or something. I'm not too sure. So
it's an issue, unfortunately, that we can't control. But
four to five will solve this issue.
Hopefully, we'll solve this issue.
I'm sure it will.
Just went onto one of the, I think it's the Benedict Aston Martin, a little bit messy through the second chicane on the Mulsanne.
Yep.
Snake Man 2008. So I'll have a wee quick run through who's actually in this lobby.
Yep, go on, you go through your lobby and then I'll go through the lobby on covering.
I'm not... Okay, it's not in order of times.
No.
So it's in order of, I'm on track. So I've got Duke of Bruno.
Yep.
In the Ford GT. TMG LaPierre, I believe.
Yep.
He is in an Aston Martin, a LMP1 car. Mm-hmm. He's also had a brush with the barrier on the right-hand side, so I don't know who that's been. See it as it come down curves. A little bit of damage on the front side. TSA Foot for CRA in the Coca-Cola Audi R18. He's currently on a 3 minute 28. LaPierre is the other LMP car on a 3 minute 26, so... Obviously the guys just warming up. This is a 45 minute session. The guys do not have to stick around for the full 45 minutes. Takumi Fujiwara for Mark VDS and Aston Martin. He is 2 minute 30.
But I do like some of these names. They're quite awesome.
We've got BG Cowboy, I think it is. Yep, in the Vodafone. Return of the Vodafone Corvette. BG Wingnut is also in this lobby, and from the sound of it, he is in a Corvette. He is in a proper British Gamers Corvette, as he just hit the Twinkies coming into the... Oh, he's made a right mess of that.
Oh, dear. Now, where's he hit the Twinkies? Is that going through...
Final chicane.
So that's going through... Oh, well, yeah, I've just seen a replay. Okay, so... Has he got a bit of damage on the car? I just noticed when he picked over, is that just you or changing
I think that was just the gear changes.
Ah, right, okay, that's fair.
Got Balmer Pie in the CRA Porsche, which is a fantastic looking car. I really, really like it. I think it's one of the best ones I've seen.
It's an awesome looking Porsche. That's one of the nice Porsches and a nice tribute there on the side of the car.
Someone was in the gravel there. Looked like a red car.
Is it a Ferrari?
I thought it might have been BG Cowboy, but... Oh, Wingnut has got a lot of damage. Well spotted.
In the vet. Oh, very good. And Matt's joined us in chat back. Hello, Matt. If you're about, you can come join me and Richie on Skype. You might be at work or busy. So he has got a bit of damage, hasn't he? He's obviously gone off somewhere. And it would be interesting to see how much that's going to slow him down the straights, that much damage. And
Well, he's hitting 176, 78.
That's still quite quick with a damaged Corvette.
180. Yeah, he's doing the same sort of speeds, but he's not going to have the braking ability for...
Did you see, is it Jan Mardenborough go all four wheels off the air in P2 going around the one of the chicanes?
Oh, no, I didn't miss that.
I'll get a picture of that. It was quite hilarious. Okay, Matt.
And Snake Man in the... That's smart. Who is off? I need to find out who's in the gravel. I'm sure there's somebody. I saw a red flash in the gravel at turn
sure.
one.
Yeah, it could have been. Sure, it wasn't one of the BG guys.
No, they're still both. It could be LaPierre. He's a little red.
I think Chris's paint's not loaded.
Maybe it's just my imagination.
Yeah. Unless they're running the old Peugeot paint, which is quite nice.
I think that's not loaded. I think CQR Chris was talking about how, or one of the CQR guys are running the Peugeot, and it will be running a Aston Martin tribute paint.
Oh, really? Oh,
the,
okay.
The day-night sort of paint. So.
Oh, nice.
And of course, there's a lot of tributes going out to Alan Simonson in this race. There's a lot of pretty much all the cars have, you know, flags and little memoriams to them. And we have a little thing planned for Saturday to start the race as well. So.
Definitely, and just.
And CRA Morfader, we missed him, in the bright blue NDRA theme.
Now, if you notice the way the car from this year at Le Mans, it's a lot different to how that's looking. It's you can see where they really developed the RA theme for this year's Le Mans, and where they concentrated on the aerodynamics, especially at the front of the car.
It was a long tail this year, wasn't it?
Yeah, long tail. Yeah, nice car. Very nice car. Toyota are very quick as well, so hopefully you'll see that in Forza 5.
Yeah, I'd love to see a good selection of sports cars in Forza 5.
Yeah.
So, I have a quick brief, I'll try and work out the fast times, but I said they seem to be a bit mixed up, because there's GT cars up in...
Yeah, I've got the second, I'll go through some of the drivers I've got in my lobby, have I got this.
LaPierre is off, he has done a 3 minute 23 and he's stopped at, it looks like the first chicane, so...
Oh. Now, has he got damage?
No, he's not got any damage. That's interesting, maybe he thinks he's set his fastest lap already. As I said, the drivers do not have to finish this lobby. It's a 45-minute session, and once the drivers believe they've reached what they can...
We can go through some of the times, can't we? Yeah, so I've got Standard Man 94 in my lobby in the Mark VDS Aston, running a very nice paint. It looks like a paint cross between the Signatec paint and the Standard Mark VDS ones. So very nice. And we've got Sierra, Dingo, Vampire... Nick James, PRT Racer, and I think Racer's in... Oh, wait for it to load up. He's running in a Porsche, which has got no paint on at the moment, so he's running the paint. Porsche, got BG Blackbird, and the Vodafone Corvette. PRT Demon, I think he's in the another beautiful-looking Porsche. It's taken on the... Porsche, of course, they're the Portuguese racing team. For some reason, he's got a bicycle on the side of his car. I just need to get a shot of that. And he's drifting that Porsche off around the corner, around Tête Rouge, on the way back onto the Mulsanne. And I've got Negus 88, and he's driving a lovely kind of base, I suppose, like a Cyber Racing Aston Martin. It looks like a bit of a green at the back. And Moti Yeti as well. In the second Ford GT, and we're going to get the times going, guys. I'll give you that date in about 10-15 minutes of times. I think the drivers have got to settle into the rhythm and get some times down.
Yeah, unfortunately we can't jump out, I can't jump in the Duncan's lobby and get what's needed. I think Mark, are you here?
Yes, I am here.
Mark is currently sitting in... Are you in the pit lane?
I am sitting at Dunlop Chicane.
That was the red car I saw.
let's get a shot of Mark. Let's get a look at the safety car for this year.
There he is. I saw something red in the first gravel trap. So Mark is in the lobby just now. He's going to be doing the safety car duties for the start of the race, I believe.
Yes.
Yes, I will.
Mark, since you've got quite a good... You'll be able to read the times better. Do you want to run through the who's going fastest so far?
I can do that.
Mark's our very own over Jim Roller. He's very good.
Currently the fastest on the chart in this lobby is TMG Lab here at a 323.5. Second so far is TSA Foot with a 326.375 in the R18. Third on the chart is Takumi Fujiwara in the Lola Aston with a 327.8. Fourth on the sheet currently is CQR Chris in the Peugeot with a 328.4. And we have CRA Morfatter in the Audi with a 329.8. So far in GTs, we have Duca Bruno in the 4GT with a 4:04. We have Bulmer Pie in the Porsche with a 409.1. Then we have Snake Man in the Aston Martin with a 436. And both BG Cowboy and BG Wingnut have yet to run a clean time, but Cowboy has a 4:04.7 and Wingnut has a 405.1. These are all as they're running.
Yep. The LMP cars and just though tonight in both lobbies are the first LMP cars out on track, because last night's one didn't run, so
no.
What we're looking at so far is provisional pole times for LMP.
Yeah, sure. I'm sure we'll see the drivers going a lot quicker into the week, but who knows? Quick question, Richie. We've got in the stream. Is it limited to how many viewers we can have, or?
I don't think so. There's nothing came up about it, so tell your friends, and we'll try and test its limits.
Yep, definitely. And if we do have a limit, we'll have to get in touch and get that limit taken away. So,
some people seem to be having issues with the chat and the stream. I'm on Chrome. I'm running everything off Chrome, and I've got it all loaded up fine for me, so I'm not really sure.
Yeah, me too. I'm on Chrome as well, so I'm not too sure if that's... Not too sure what's going on. Oh, God, I've just had a car go off down... Where is this? Oh, this is the run down to Indianapolis, and it's Stan, and he's totaled the car going to Indianapolis. He's gone in there very, very hard. He's
done.
He's gone in there. I do feel sorry for Stan, because he... He did put an entry in. I can't remember if it was ITC. He tried to put an entry. Oh, that's right, ITC. He put an entry in for an NMP1 car, and you're supposed to put a GT car. And all the GT.
Are they going to try to retrieve the car out of the gravel pit?
Yeah, he's carried on. He's now. He's got massive damage though. He's that car is totaled for the race. He's going to have to make its way back to the garage. There's a side impact as well. So when he's lost it, he's lost it on the entrance to the Porsche curves now. So I think Stan might be. Stan might be leaving this one out, and he's so far set a 3:26 407, and it was a clean lap as well.
He's in the Aston Martin LMP car, isn't he?
He is, yeah.
His teammate Takumi has done 3:27, so that's and he's stopped on track as well. So
Stan's better that lap time by a second. So I think Stan's obviously he might peel off into pits now when he gets the four chicane.
LaPierre. Has been asked. He is in first with a 3:23.
I'm going to go through. Let me go through this with the drivers. So Stan's done a 3:36. Oh, what was that?
LaPierre.
I've got CRA Lingo Dingo. He's in a 3:28.752 in the R18. This is X Ramp. In the third of the Lola Aston Martins for Mark V tonight, so he's in a 3:29.362. So Stan still set the provisional fast lap for that team. That Aston does seem very slidey going into the first corner, the first chicane. It's does not very stable in the rear, so I might have to look at some rear downforce for that car over long distance. Going to GTs, Nick James 1-2-3 has done a 3:59 in the Stanley Powered 4 GT. Move on into BG Blackbird in the Vodafone Corvette, and he hasn't got any damage, but he's so far done a 4:01.983, so he's getting the car up to temperature. PRT Racer in the Porsche 997, the 2011 version with the rear the wider body art work is in a 4:02.026. And I don't know if you guys noticed in Le Mans the past weekend, the couple of the teams were running the older Porsche with the 2011 version instead of the 2012 RSR, while the Porsche factory were running a Porsche GTE 911, which we expect that car not to be back at Le Mans next year, and I think we're going to see replaced by the brand new GT3 RSR. No news if Porsche are going to be running a factory program in both categories next year as yet. PRT Demon driving the second Porsche is in a 4:05.956, so he's a couple of seconds off his teammate, and that Porsche does seem to be very, very rear happy with Demon running through the run out to the Corvette corner. Got Negus 88. I think Negus is going to load up in the Aston Martin DBR1, who's doing fairly well actually. He's doing so far running a 4:06.321 the Aston, but he has got heavy damage, and he looks like he's had an incident through the Porsche curve. So a lot of drivers going off in the Porsche curves. He's got front end damage and rear side impact. So in an Aston as well, you're going to be losing a lot of time around there. So still seems to be able to keep that car on track. And last in my lobby, Moti Yeti. I think he's in an NMP or GT. He's in the last 4 GT first full GT of Mark BDS, and he's in a 416.003. He's had no damage, so you know it's all about keeping the car on track for 24 hours. And if he's getting no damage for the lobbies and not getting incidents, he could be doing what majority of the AM drivers do and just keep your all wheel on the track and make your way around. Hopefully we're not going to see anybody have a Tracy Crone accident, what we saw in free practice last week, which was quite nasty, going into the tyre barrier and leading the whole of his 458.
That was right at the S's, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was a big impact. Did you see where they got the car from? They got the car from the Superstars series, the Italian, the Superstars Sprint series. So they got a Ferrari, especially transported it there, which was very interesting. And I wouldn't be surprised if we see some Ferrari-powered LMP2 machinery next year from a certain AF Corsa linked LMP2 team. That's what I hear in the grapevine. Let's get back to our race. And anything going on in your lobby, Mark? Any times changing?
Well, let's see. Let's see. Morfatter's got a little bit faster time than the past. He's leapfrogged over CQR Chris.
Yep.
Wingnut finally has got a clean time of a 405.4. And so far, BG Cowboy is the only one left who hasn't run a clean lap yet.
Okay. What time's what's the fastest GT time so far?
Fastest GT would still be Duca Bruno with a 4:04.
Okay, so we've still got one driver. I think it was James, wasn't it? Nick James in the 359s in the 4 GT in 9W. How about LMP?
LMP would still be TMG Lapierre at 3:23.5.
That's a very quick time as well. So it'll be interesting to see how.
What's Nick James' fastest time?
Nick James, if I go to him, I think I'm sick. He so far has done a 3:59.891, so it's a thousandth between the two teammates in the 4 GT with Duca Bruno. I think he was about 4 minutes, wasn't he?
Yeah, it was a 4:00.412.
So I think Nick James set this lap very early on, so the tyres were very fresh. And it's strange because some drivers do seem to go a lot quicker early on the stint than when the fuel load goes down, so interesting to see how drivers attack the Porsche curves. And it's good to see there's no dirt braking going on here.
No, there's not,
because we'll be throwing drivers out of the event for spotting that, so that's a fury warning.
Yeah, it's slightly frowned upon here. Yeah, I think personally, I find the car goes a bit quicker at the start because the tyres are a bit grippier. If we do our normal stints, from what I remember from last year, the car starts to go off and then comes back again after about an hour and a half or so.
Yes.
Maybe we'll get less than an hour and 50 minutes or so. So towards the end of the session, I feel that the car is not as good as it was at the start. So.
Yeah, and it's very strange. I find, I'm like Ian, our of an M&M driver. We're both very quick on cold tyres, but when Ian carries on getting quicker, I just go slower. So if I did the race without to change my tyres every lap, I think it'd be quite good. But yeah, apart from that, oh dear.
Yeah, it's we should totally have done drag tyres.
Yes. Well, hopefully on Forza, you know, 5,
maybe more. Apparently Forza 5's got different compounds, but I've not seen it yet.
Really? Different compounds of tyre?
Apparently. I've not seen anything, but apparently somebody said it was true. So.
You know, you can set the setting to Lomond, mid-warning, put super soft tyres on, go very quick.
Yeah, well, some people could put super softs on and go quick, and then some people could put hards on and then go slightly slower but go longer. Yeah. Things like that.
Oh, we don't get to. Oh no, it's gonna be pretty. All the rubber degradation flying off.
Yeah, we're gonna get like really dirty cars and stuff like that. That's actually happening. Yeah. Snake Man in the Aston Martin actually has a bit of damage in the front. It's got quite a lot of damage in the front.
He has got quite a lot of damage, and that's coming down small sand corner, getting that down towards Nige and Indianapolis.
Everybody on the stream, as usual, there's going to be a slight delay between me, who's watching Xbox, and Duncan and Mark, who are watching the stream.
I'll respond
to something quite quickly and then like a slight delay. Although it's not as bad as Eurosports one was.
No, you see, people weren't listening to me. You have to VLC media player, put radio them on their stream, direct stream through VLC, pause it for 3 seconds, and then go back to the Eurosport. Perfect sync.
Unfortunately, you can't do that here. I don't know if there's like a way. I could just not say anything. I could just switch my Xbox off and just watch the stream. That would be.
That could work, couldn't it?
Although saying that, see when you watch it back, I'm in perfect time with everything, and everyone else is slightly delayed. So you know, my commentary is slightly. What we need is a commentary booth.
It needs to be a commentary booth, and we need to be at Circuit de la Surf, and we need to be at Le Mans. Oh, look, we might have to do that next year.
Yeah, maybe we could do like the Le Mans 24 Hours virtually at Le Mans in a real commentary booth, and then everyone could play online.
Well, we could do that, or we could watch the race and do it on the Friday. Oh, I know, the Friday before Le Mans, we'll do our 24-hour race, up until the start, the actual race.
Yeah, so we did 24 hours and start, and then they did real 24 hours, and so we were up for 40 hours watching everything.
I think that's got to be done.
TSA Foot had a bit of an issue coming through the exit of the Porsche curves there. Anybody that's wondering, this is qualifying, so collisions are off, but damage is still on, so if you mess up and hit the wall, you're going to have damage, obviously. But you don't have to get out of the way of traffic, so you can, you know, there's no excuse for getting a dirty lap and things like that. So
got a couple of people in the chat back asking about how many stints drivers can do. I think we are imposing a stint.
There's not a stint cap, so people can do as many as they want. Yeah. However, there is no double stint allowed between stint 6 and 7. So if you've got a driver that's doing the double stint there, stint 7 will start at 2 a.m. in the morning, no matter what. So if you've got somebody with who's doing a double stint over 6 and 7, it's been in the rules from the start. You know, it's always been there. So if you have got somebody who's delayed in stint 6, then you've got to either make the choice of quitting stint six and getting into stint seven as soon as possible, or giving up stint seven and not doing it. If that makes sense. I hope it makes sense. It's to stop us getting delays. Because what ends up happening at Le Mans is the fact that because there's that many lobbies going to run, I think there's going to be 4 lobbies running for this race again. There will inevitably be 10-minute delays here or 5-minute delays here, and it's going to cause a bit of a delay overall. So the stint 6 and 7 stoppage or, you know, sort of reset is so we can get rid of any delays that happens in the first 6 hours and just have 6 hours of, you know, to worry about at the end of it.
You mean 12?
12 hours, yes. Because 6 hours would be a luxury.
Yeah, and collisions are on for the race, but off for qualifying, if you ask me. So, yeah, and damage will be set to limited. Yes, not simulation, because we don't want to repeat of, I think, the first endurance race we did.
Yeah.
Simulation damage, and so we lagged into everybody at the start of the race.
However, it is simulation damage in the ISCC.
It is, yes. We still get entries. I think we've got about 6 team entries left for LMPC, and how we're classifying this year, even if you drive with one driver, you can bump your driver up to 3 teammates to fill that spot if you wish to change from privateer. And I think we've got about 21 or 20 entries left in LMP. One GTE is full. GTE teams are still running privateer, so if you're a GTE driver and you want to get involved in GTE, just message some drivers and ask if you can run with them, because they are still free to expand their team from a privateer to a team.
It's a slightly awkward system. It's not quite worked out how we originally planned. However, we hit the 75 driver limit pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm.
But any privateers that are in, if you're still wanting to enter the race, you know, join a team that already exists and you will get a car. It's not limited to 75 drivers. It was just 75
team
cars initially. I think that's how we worked out. It's a little bit awkward, but you know, basically we're trying to keep under the 200 driver cap, and I think we're getting pretty close to that, because I think
we are.
But, you know, God knows, we'll never hit 200 people in one night. It's not going to happen, is it?
I wouldn't say. Well, depending on what this prize is pretty big. You know, the prize we're giving away is pretty big. And I don't know if you guys have seen, Fan Attack have been actually releasing some statements saying, obviously, they're not officially supported for the next Xbox Forza 4, but not being the main wheel, but they are looking at to do software upgrades for all the wheels to be compatible with the new Xbox One.
That'll be good. Oh, that's a big...
Which can happen if you do a software upgrade in the kit, so it's using your free software. So hopefully, fingers crossed, that'd be quite a good idea.
The only way, like, it'll connect just like you do with the PS3 and the PC. You have to plug it into the USB.
Yeah, it'll connect it.
The wireless is only for the Xbox 360 on the CSR and CSR Elite. Mm-hmm. But you just plug them into the PC and the PS3 and they work perfectly fine. They work really well, so it's going to be just the same sort of thing.
Exactly, it'll work well. And, you know, are we going to, I think, yeah, we are, should we talk about what we're planning to do for the rest of the year?
Not yet,
okay.
We don't have anything concrete. But it is a huge thing. GT Omega again has given us a rig to give away once again.
Yes.
And we're topping it all off with a full CSR Elite set.
Pedaling wheels.
Pedaling wheels. No shifter set. We didn't get them when we
But they're quite cheap to buy, aren't they? They're not too expensive. So
yeah, they're only about £30 or something like that, I think. So.
Yeah, and a full racing rig. And these rigs are awesome with the Elite. And the wheel just... it's just any of the games. It is amazing. So I'm quite jealous, actually.
And, it's... good luck to all the winners. As we kind of outlined with it, any event you take part in, you will get a ticket. So the more races you race in, the more tickets you get.
Yeah.
And then at the end of there's a Aston Martin just. So Aston Martin smoking going through the Porsche curves. It looked like Snake Man. Oh, a lot of damage. Lots and lots of damage.
So we got there. That's Snake Man. He's oh dear, he's done. Was that on the entrance to the Porsche Girls, or had you done that before?
I'm not sure. I just saw, I was on board with LaPierre, and he was just, I saw a smoking Aston Martin as we came through.
See, so drivers have got to slow down. Obviously, he's qualifying, but come to race, you want to be going, this is technically a sprint race, you know, nowadays. I mean, they used to run in the 80s and the early 90s, especially the 90s, and about 90% of the drivers reckon 80% half the race because they didn't want to damage the cars, but nowadays it is a sprint, but... still have damage if you go off through the Porsche curves. You know, the most one of the most challenging corners in, I think, on the game actually, to get that line perfect through there. If you've got a very low downforce car, it's very difficult in a GT car.
Yeah. CQR Chris has been in the wall on the left hand side of the car. Oh, big tank slapper coming through.
What is that on? No.
CQR Chris.
Yeah, that's going down towards Indianapolis, isn't it? Yeah, and then to Indy.
But he is up to third now in this lobby, so LaPierre is still first with 323.581, so I don't think it's changed.
323?
Yeah.
Stan's still got 326 in the Aston Lola.
So we're looking at LaPierre in pole position currently.
And then I'm just going to check whatever GT car, I think that's NMP car. Nick James just stopped out on the opposite. The car, he's got damage actually, he's gone off, so he's gone off. Yeah, he's got quite a lot of suspension damage. It looked like he's had an impact at Tête Rouge, on the exit of Tête Rouge actually, and he's gone off, and he's still got a 359.891, so I think he's calling it quits there. PRT Racer in the Porsche. He's done a 401.520, so that's a very quick time in that Porsche around here, and he's got no damage, so he's still travelling around, and I think he's got 20 minutes to go, 25 minutes to go.
Change in the GTE pole position. BG Cowboy, who is in the pits with 10 minutes to go, has done a 4 minute 2.424.
Yeah.
I think that's one of the quickest, unless there's someone quicker in your lobby, Duncan.
402. What time was that, sorry, Richie?
402.424.
Nick James has still done a 359 in that car. Then that's, let me look up and find another BG Blackbird. And the second couple there has actually gone quicker. He's done a 401.983 in the Vodafone BG. And he does seem to be running a bit more downforce than the vets we're running. So that can, might be a bit interesting when it comes to... race day.
Yeah, it's We'll go through our build later.
Where am I going to be going?
Oh, we've got the other BG car stopped at Tête Rouge with huge amount of damage, so I think Twinkie strike again.
Yep.
Just coming onto the main straight.
Ooh.
A lot of damage there.
That Twinkies, you got to watch out for them Twinkies down to Tête Rouge. It's a very fast corner. And a driver's going flat out there in the GT cars, or you're coming off?
You can, well, what I found when I was doing a bit of testing was if you just hitting third gear and then accelerating all the way through the corner,
mm-hmm.
you get a nice line that pulls you right across, but you are pretty close to, you know.
Yeah, and you've got over, just a reminder for drivers, GT drivers stick to your line, NMP drivers go around, and always just call outs and be aware of your observations, use mirrors.
I mean, we're fortunate that we can talk to each other in the lobbies. However, the slower car is not really to move.
Yeah,
it's the faster car's, you know, responsibility to get around you safely. Obviously, if you're going down the Mulsanne and the GTE car is in the racing line and there's like a LMP battle coming through, I have seen cars in Le Mans at the weekend getting out of the way of LMP cars, but I wouldn't recommend it. I'd just, you know, let them do their thing.
Yep, it's down to the LMP driver to get make safety. However, did you see Anthony Davison almost being getting taken out by a P2 car and a Ferrari when he tried to squeeze in the middle going down the run down to the second chicane? I think it must have been on, was it a night? Was it a night or the afternoon, early hours? It was very early hours. I think it was just out before the lead GT Pro Aston crashed, and he was very lucky not to get taken out there. And
I did see Anthony Davison coming into the Mulsanne corner with a Ferrari right in front of him, and then it spun. And they must have just been thinking, oh, not again, as it was going through it, because it was just...
again.
It was like, if he'd been like a little bit further back, they would have taken each other out or something.
I know. But that Toyota did show that. I was impressed by that Toyota in the rain. I mean, the mixed conditions, that Toyota was quick. Very, very quick. And it's good. Next year, I think next year they're going to be a very strong challenger next year for the overall win.
I hope so, but Porsche's coming back next year as well.
Yeah, Porsche got better in there. They're going to come and do it's going to be a 5-year program or 3-year program, isn't it? So 1 year to return up, test. Second year, slight chance of winning. Third year, that's when you go for the win. What's that Bentley did? And Bentley as well, maybe? Rumors?
Yeah, I heard them talking about that on the Eurosport stream.
That'd be nice to see.
It's interesting because what is Bentley's? Is it part of the VAG group?
Yeah, VAG, isn't it? So it's good. It could be a big VAG company eventually, couldn't it?
That's interesting because I wouldn't have thought Audi would want to share the competition.
Well,
see, now isn't Porsche VAG? No.
Yeah, Porsche's VAG. Yeah.
Yeah.
All
right.
Yeah. If you remember, Porsche tried to buy out VAG group with. A dodgy stock deal which backfired on them and they got bought out. which is still not Bentley GT. Simon, you're correct. Obviously GT3, they've got a GT3 Bentley, but we've got new GT rules coming in 2015, 2014, I think it's 2015, where they are still want to merge GT GT3 together to create one global GT class. So I think the SRO group is finally coming around, still showing some resistance to that idea. But we might, you know, one day, you know, 2 years time, we might see Mercedes, BMW, Z4s, Ferraris at Le Mans, which would be fantastic.
I'm surprised that Z4 GTE car wasn't there.
It wasn't homologated by the ACO. It had been given waivers by IMSA and permission to run in the American Le Mans series, but the ACO and the FIA actually haven't homologated that car. I think there's some teams, I think it's Ferrari and the factory Porsche team, and the Astons are a bit unhappy about some of the bodywork in that car. It's not the same as the other cars, but I mean, it'd be fantastic to see this group, and I think, you know, there's going to be a big split. I don't know if you guys...
Right. We have just had a complete lobby split, whereas Mark is the only car left. Now Mark's left, right, okay, the lobby has just crashed with 5 minutes to go.
Oh dear.
That's fantastic. Hey, there's me!
Well, if I send you an invite to here, I've got a five, we can get the second lobby going, because there's only a few people in here, so...
I'll jump into stands.
Is there a lobby left, or is that Mark there? Mark's still here. So we'll find out what's happening. Mark's going to try and get all the times from the other guys, so don't worry for that. But if we're going back onto the GT regs, Richie, do you know there's going to be a lot of teams, a lot of developers are splitting now between the classic road verse version of GT cars? There's a lot of teams going towards the DTM, GT5 engine, GT300 route. So there's going to be obviously be an interesting split when it comes to the future for the American Le Mans Series and the world's what they call the United Sports Car Championship with their GT program. They're using a spec chassis and a different engine you could slot into your GT car. So be interesting to see in a couple of years what kind of GT cars we have running around Le Mans.
Sorry, I'm just trying to work out if we got all the times from that last lobby.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I was literally just about to run through times.
Yep, hello. Just about even your times. I'm going to go through our times in here. You're getting into the lobby. So you guess you can get a look. We'll wait for you to load up. And it's going to be, fantastic.
Yes, Simon, I'll have a chat with you after this. I think I've got a chat with the BG guys as well, but I'll chat with you.
Yeah, what's your stream on Twitch? We can promote it to the world.
Spigs TV, I think.
Spigs TV, that's very good. He's enters a lot of gaming now, and it's good to see.
Right, I don't have any of the paints lead for some reason. I think it may be my internet that was a little bit dodgy there, so...
Yeah.
that's great. That's a great confidence sign for... for Le Mans this weekend, isn't it?
Five minutes to go. We have the top five cars on the same mileage. Oh, which is disconnected. And the lobby's crashed.
Nick James. Oh yeah, I've got like all the basic cars in here. Nick James, 359.892. He stopped at Tête Rouge. Don't think he's got any damage. I think he's just finished racing now. PRT Racer, 481.520 Porsche. PG Blackboard, 1.983. PRT Demon, 4:05.334. Moto Yeti, 4:14.880 in the Ford GT. Negu 88. Negus 88, 4:05.952. That's interesting.
That is interesting, isn't it? What time did he do? 5:05, so yep.
Standerman seems to be the quickest in this lobby in LMP1, 3:26.407 with a lot of damage.
Yeah, a lot of damage, yeah.
CRA Lingdingo, that's a great name. 3:27.265 has just stopped, and they only got 50 seconds left in this lobby anyway, so obviously that's the guys finishing up. Vampire, 3:29.362.
I just had a request for someone to get the stream, if I can get him on. Let me just get him.
So, yeah, sorry about that, a little pause in the coverage there. Right, that was not intentional. So... that is qualifying 2 with only a few seconds left to go. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Stop.
Yep, that's qualifying 2 for the Le Mans 24 Hours done. We will get the times updated as soon as possible. It looks like Nick James is on provisional pole with a 3:59.891 in GTE.
Mm-hmm.
And it was Lapierre in LMP1 with a 3:23, I think he had, with 3:23.4.
Yeah.
So, it's looking good. I'm not actually sure of what the fast Le Mans times, the fast LMP times will be, but a 59 looks like it's going to be pretty competitive.
2 minutes, just miss out the whole chicanes and come back up the old 60s route and miss out the Porsche curves and go straight back up at 200 miles an hour. Oh dear. So we've still got some cars circulating. Stan's gonna.
Yeah, I saw a couple coming in from.
Yeah, Stan's still going to get the.
Stan's not going to be getting there.
Getting their times, so that's giving them everything faster their times. So Stan's obviously getting the times down now, guys. And I do see Mr. Big say hello. Oh.
I did read that, I was when I was listening to the Eurosport coverage, we were talking about McLaren, and people were asking why GTT cars went in GTE, and they were saying that cars are all similar, but there's different, like, it's all internal parts of the car that are different for GTE.
Yeah.
McLaren have built GT3 cars, but designed a GTE car, so yeah. It's there to be built. But they don't want to do it. I don't think they've got
I would just say watch at Goodwood Festival of Speed in July.
Well, I don't think it'll be a good idea because, you know, United Sports Car is changing all the rules over there next year.
Mm-hmm.
SRO is changing all the rules for GTE in a couple of years' time, so I don't see why they would waste a year building a new car, unless they become a Garage 56. But Garage 56 next year is already that Delta Wing.
The Nissan. Which is a Delta Wing.
Yeah, it's a coupe Delta Wing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's because it's designed by the same guy who did the Delta Wing. He's gone to work for Nissan, so...
it's not actually the Delta Wing?
No.
I thought it was the coupe Delta Wing.
No. The Delta Wing coupe is a Delta Wing coupe. This one's called Matalno. What's the name of the Nissan? Matalno.
Not like an EOS or something like that.
Yeah, But they still haven't worked out how it's actually going to work. They're aiming for 200 miles an hour top speed, which would be incredible in an electric car with...
That'd be scary in a Delta Wing.
no rear wing. It's going to be... there was some quite funny comments about, I suggested on the Midweek Motorsport thread on Facebook that they should have an engine sound, and when the guy members there posted up a sound of like ice cream van at full blast. Like, so you're just sitting up with a more fan corner. Oh, here comes electric car.
It's like a milk float.
Exactly. It'd be very, very interesting. Someone joined us. I have even missed the call.
Well, Stan is currently collecting the time, so there's a couple of cars still chilling around at the back.
Yeah, the ZRC or ZODRC race car, so the zero, or the, I don't know, zero emissions.
RC, remote control.
That would be awesome, wouldn't it?
Just sit in the pit lane and just control your car.
Simon, is that, I think about the hybrid, the hydrogen power car, wasn't ready. It will make an appearance, we are told, at a WEC event later in the year. To do some runs, and it's still programmed to be developed, and I think we'll see that car running some point next year somewhere, so be interesting. And it was very interesting to see you talk about the United Sports Car Series, the head of that series actually waving them off, and I think there's going to still be a big time between Le Mans and the American series over there, so obviously Louis Sattler, our American racer, has big ties to that series, hence his own creation of the name, and still heavily involved in discussions. Be very good. And we joined. Who are there? Who's that? Oh, that's Simon.
That was me.
Hey, hello.
Sorry, just before... Mark, are you finished your lobby now, then?
The lobby has finished, and I have gathered all the times I have, from everyone that was in here.
Okay, since I got kicked out of it, can you please just read through them so we know what's going on?
Alright, well, okay, TSA Foot has a 326-375. CRA Morfatter has a 327-5. TMG Lapierre, a 323-581. Takumi Fujiwara, a 327-826. CQR Chris, a 325-769. Bruno left a little early, a 4:00.412. BG Cowboy, a 4:00.725. BG Wingna, a 4:02.728. Balmier Pie, 671, got a 407, 572. And the Snake Man 2008 had a 429, 921.
Pretty good spread of times, aren't they? They're pretty close. You can see that what drivers are starting to stand out. I think that's this lobby starting to finish off as well. I think I'll get the times off Stan and update them once we are finished. Qualifying on Wednesday night is at 10 p.m. British Summer Time, which is about, I think it's like 5 or 6 or something like that.
10 o'clock your time would be 5 o'clock my time.
5 o'clock US... Okay, 4 o'clock US Central Time on Wednesday. And that session is the only session on Wednesday, so there's both, you know, UK and US sessions are on that. There is, I don't think there's one tonight.
No, there's not one tonight.
Yeah, because it was last night's one was the initial kickoff.
Mm-hmm.
Friday night we have got the support races and qualifying four and qualifying five is at 8 p.m. Central. Again, which is the final qualifying session before the start of the race. The support races we'll go into in further detail on Wednesday. In fact, it's not going to be streamed on Wednesday because I think I'm racing then.
I could just do it on boards from you. I can talk about that.
Could do. 7 p.m. we'll be kicking off the first support race before qualifying.
Yep.
It'll be the return of the Open Cup for the first, 45 minutes. Then we'll do qualifying from 8 p.m. onwards. Then we'll have the classic race, and then we'll have the third Open Cup.
Yeah, final race. And
that'll be us for sport races, and the final qualifying will be on at the end of Friday, and then we'll start the race at 2 p.m. BST on Saturday for 24 hours.
And we're still keeping the scoring how we did on Sebring, so it'll be distance between leader, and we'll be working out the total distance around the track in feet.
Yeah, so like every time somebody finishes a stint, the car will just stop on track. There will be no continuing across the line or stopping at the nearest mile and all that kind of stuff.
No.
So it'll be nice and accurate. Well, that was fun.
That was good fun.
Good to be back to kick off the long week.
This is,
as I said, we will be back for the. Well, we'll be back for the, we're back on Friday night for a full live night. Jake Sanson may be appearing on Friday night. Hopefully will be, and then we'll have build up for the race on Saturday as well with some special programs, so look forward to that.
It's going to be awesome. I can't wait, and be good, and good luck to all the competitors taking Le Mans if we don't see you till Saturday. Best of luck.
Yep, thanks for listening, and we will see you soon. Thank you.